Hi all, it's Andy from Solar Reviews here. I just wanted to talk to you today about solar panel cost. Obviously, it's a very important topic. Whenever you're buying anything, you want to get the best deal you can. And so part of that is to, you know, have, you know, some feedback on what price should you be paying for solar? What's a good price in your area for solar? And I'll talk about that generally, and then I'll show you how to find out exactly what size system you need on your specific home, and then see local prices on that system. When I talk about solar panel cost, I'm talking about fully installed, professionally installed and manage solar systems where the solar company does everything for you. They supply the equipment, they install the panels, they give you a warranty, 10-year warranty on labor. They do the permit for the authority of jurisdiction. They do the inspection for the authority of jurisdiction after it's installed. They do the paperwork for the utility, and they do a utility inspection if your utility requires one. And the reason I do that is because 95% of people, if not more, ultimately choose a professionally installed system from a local solar company, because it's a difficult process to install solar. And if you're a DIY customer, which means you buy the kit online and then you get somebody else to install it, what tends to happen is nobody wants to support you going forward. And you become a bit of what we often term as a solar orphan. So because of that, 95% of people choose to go with a reputable local licensed installer to do that whole job, knowing full well that if anything ever happens with the system, there's one point of contact and one company that's responsible for that system. So in terms of solar panel cost, we're looking at between probably 240 at the low end per watt and 280 at the upper end per watt. It's funnily enough, the cheaper prices, like they're around the 240 a watt mark, you tend to find them in states where power prices are lower. And I guess they've had to be competitive to sell solar because the investment return isn't as good as what it is in other places. So states where people tend to use a lot more power, so like Texas and Florida and places like this, the average system size there is, you know, usually probably 11 kilowatts, 10 or 11 kilowatts in Florida and Texas. Whereas in other states, you know, the average system size is more like 6 or 7 kilowatts. So where systems tend to be bigger, prices tend to be lower. But, you know, generally speaking, we're talking in a range of 240 to 270. And, you know, to be quite frank, if people were selling below that lower mark of 240, I'd actually be really concerned about their longevity as a business. Because more than anything, as a solar company, your panel is going to last 25 years. You want a solar company that's going to answer your phone for 25 years. So more than a cheap price, we all want a cheap price, but more than a cheap price, I want a good price from somebody that will be available to support me for the next 25 years. And that's really, as a solar buyer, that's what I'm looking for. I'm not looking for the absolute best deal, because that will almost always either be on cheap gear, cheap brands or inferior equipment, or it will be from a company that probably doesn't have a sustainable pricing model and probably won't be there in the future. Price is just one of the elements. Solar panels being a 25 to 30 year product, it's a very long time to go without support. And so making sure you're a company, you buy from a company that's going to be there, is a very, very, very important thing with solar panels, much more so than with other consumer goods you may buy, where you're really only expecting, you know, 2 or 5 or 10 years life out of the product. If we average out the states where people use a lot of power and they don't, you know, in between there, we're probably talking about the average size system being around 8 kilowatts. So if we're talking about a, you know, around the 250 a mark, 250 per watt, cost per watt mark, then we're talking about $22,000 for a solar system before the tax credit. In 2021, there's a 22% tax credit. So, you know, that will bring that back towards $16,000 or so for an 8 kilowatt system professionally installed. If you pay that sort of money, then the payback can be anywhere from, you know, 3 to 4 to 5 years in places like maybe Massachusetts, New Jersey, California, because power's expensive there. And there's, in the case of Massachusetts and New Jersey, also New York, there's very good incentives. So there's also that significantly further reduce the cost beyond the federal tax credit. You know, even in places where power is very cheap, like Florida and Texas, and to a lesser extent, say Utah, South Carolina, Oregon, Washington, you know, in these places, you know, you're still talking about a 10% return on your money. And so I think the reason so much solar gets sold in places, these places like Florida and Texas and the like, is that money in the bank now is giving you 0% or close to it. And so a solar system offering 10% is, you know, really quite attractive as an investment. It's, I believe it's a better investment return even in those places than what the long-term return is from both shares or the property market. So, you know, the other thing I think that's really helped solar as well, it's a little bit off topic, it's more talking about solar return rather than solar cost, but Zillow published a study, I think it was in 2019, that basically said that solar panels increased the average value of a home they installed on by 4.1%, which is pretty significant, because even without the power bill savings, it appears that putting solar on a home increases its attractiveness and value by more than the cost of the solar system. So there's an instant capital uplift you get from a solar project. Mind you would also get an instant capital uplift if you, say, put a new kitchen in or something like that. What you really want to know when you're talking about solar panel cost is how much solar will cost for your specific home. And so on our site, we've spent many, many years and more money than I'd care to remember developing a calculator that has the utility rates in it for every utility around the country. It has the irradiation levels from every, I think there's about 3,500 weather stations around America. So it has the utility and irradiation and therefore the solar production for every climatic zone in the country. So that calculator, all you need to do is put your address, because obviously we need to know the location to work out the solar production. From simply your address and the dollar value you spend on power, we're able to reverse engineer how many solar panels you need, tell you what size solar system you need. We even have some artificial intelligence that actually measures your roof and draws the solar panels on your roof. And then we're able to tell you exactly what size system you need. And then from all the local pricing we've seen in the area, being the biggest solar marketplace, I guess, where consumers seek quotes from solar companies in America, we're able to see a lot of quotes that go through our site, you know, up to 1,000 a day. So we have pretty accurate idea of pricing in various regions. So we're able to average out and show you a cost estimate for your specific home based on your specific use, based on average prices. And then if you wish to, you can actually select to get an actual binding bid from between 1 and 4 solar companies on our website. So I absolutely recommend you do that. Solar's a great thing. And as I said earlier, it is a far better investment than what most people realize. And there's not often that, you know, mum and dads, you know, like us, get to do something where, you know, effectively it's very close to a risk-free return, because, you know we're going to continue to use power, and even if we leave the house or sell the house, we know that the capital value from studies that have been done by Zillow and others, we know that the capital value of the home will increase by at least what we spend, if not more. So I absolutely commend you to head on over to one of our websites, solarreviews.com or solar-estimate.org, and, you know, take a look and use the calculator for yourself and find out exactly how much it will cost to install solar panels on your home. Bye for now. Have a good day.